one thing. When I read any book, I first read about the author so that I know where the author is coming from. In light of that information, then when I consume the book, it makes much more, I understand it much more, where the person is coming from, why would he be saying. So it helps me check the absoluteness of the claim of the author. I think that's one useful thing which one can do. It helped me. When I'm reading the book on Mozart, there's one lady. So that's who's written that, the first check, who are these people who've written it? What would be, I am not saying these are evil agenda. We are all human beings, we have limitations of thought, we have stands that we take, we have our own answers. And we'll obviously write around that. So when I understand that, the book, I'm able to see it in perspective. It helps that.
There is a famous Nasruddin Khaja story, most legends work on that. Nasruddin, you might have heard perhaps. One day Nasruddin Khaja was sleeping and he found some people going. So he said that just for a prank. And he woke up, a lot of people are going. She in the Khalif's palace, they are giving biryani. So everybody started running with the biryani. Nasruddin Khaja also started running with her. And he's laughing and running. So somebody asked, Khaja, why are you laughing? He said that these fools, they are running. I just made a crack, I told them they are giving biryani, they are not running. But why are you running? Yeah. And Khaja said, what if they are really giving biryani? So most of the religious songs are like that. Somebody would have made a little, any god, Ganesha or Mahesha, what if we give something and I don't go there and I visit
Khaja? Oh, Mr. Chan.
That is true actually. That is true, right?